Please stand as you are able for the opening hymn number 613.
Of sin and cannot break free. We hoard resources while our neighbors are hungry and cold. We speak in ways that silence others. We are silent when we should speak up. We keep score in our hearts. We let hurts grow into hatred. For all these things and for sins only you know, forgive us, Lord. Amen.
Here is a flood of grace. Out of love for the whole world, God draws near to us, breaks every snare of sin, washes away our wrongs, and restores the promise of life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Holy God, Heavenly Father, in the waters of the flood you saved the chosen, and in the wilderness of temptation you protected your Son from sin. Renew us in the gift of baptism. May your holy angels be with us, that the wicked foe may have no power over us. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Trust in you.
Let me not be put to shame, nor let my enemies triumph over me.
Let none who look to you be put to shame. Rather, let those be put to shame who are treacherous.
Show me your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths.
Lead me in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. In you I have trusted all the day long.
Remember, O Lord, your compassion and love, for they are from everlasting.
Remember not the sins of my youth and my transgressions. Remember me according to your steadfast love, and for the sake of your goodness, O Lord.
You are gracious and upright, O Lord. Therefore you teach sinners in your way.
You lead the lowly in justice and teach the lowly your way.
All your paths, O Lord, are steadfast love and faithfulness to those who keep your covenant and your testimonies.
A reading from 1 Peter. Christ also suffered for sins once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, in order to bring you to God. He was put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the spirit, in which also he went and made a proclamation to the spirits in prison, who in former times did not obey, when God waited patiently in the days of Noah during the building of the ark, in which a few, that is eight persons, were saved through water. And baptism, which this prefigured, now saves you, not as a removal of dirt from the body, but as an appeal to God for a good conscience, through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers made subject to him. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus saw the heavens opening and the Spirit descending on him like a dove. Then a voice came from the heavens. You are my beloved, my own. On you my favor rests. Immediately the Spirit drove Jesus out into the wilderness, and he remained there for 40 days and was tempted by Satan. He was with the wild beasts, and the angels looked after him. After John's arrest, Jesus appeared in Galilee proclaiming the good news of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The reign of God is at hand. Change your hearts and minds and believe the good news. This is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Let us pray, holy and precious one. We thank you that you have again gathered us in worship. Continue to send us your Holy Spirit, that we might know your way and your will for our lives. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
If you haven't figured it out, I'm not Pastor Pam. She was feeling a little bit under the weather this morning, so I don't know how he's getting drafted into this. There's two things kind of before the sermon I want to point out. Yesterday we had a wonderful funeral for Pastor Bruce Johnston, who served for many years in the church. And Pam didn't know this and I didn't know this, but we found out at the funeral yesterday that one of the things he did was he was in the March on Washington. And he was also one of the representatives representatives of the four synods that form the ELCA. So it's kind of powerful when you hear about that. And it reminded me of how connected we are as the church. And another connection, that wonderful hymn we opened with this morning, My Holy Wings, that is a beautiful hymn. It's a lullaby. And back, 4 years ago, Gracia Grindahl, the person who translated it, gave the hymn and the music to my wife, who typeset it, because we had a computer that could typeset music. So that was the first version. So that's how connected we are as a church. And it's so important to remember those connections. And as we sit here today, as we gather to worship, we heard that wonderful story from Noah. The story of God's promise. A promise that is solidified and shown to us in the bowl, in the rainbow in the sky. A promise that God has made a covenant with us. So if you want to make sure, and you want to know about that promise, every time we gather in this place to worship, we are under the rainbow. It's in the middle of the back window, right under Jesus' feet. It's hiding. But when we gather, we are under the promise of the rainbow. Yeah, you gotta really look to find it. Yep. Yeah. And I think that's important as the people of God to remember that we are bathed in that promise. And it's so important to remember that we live a life of faith. And this is something my wife handed me this morning. A life of faith is like journeying in the wilderness. Given faith's unpredictable nature and our highly dynamic environment, people of faith need a navigation system. Just as a compass orients travelers, people of faith need reliable reference points and directions to find their way. We need, as people of God, to be grounded. And what we are grounded in is faith and in God's promises. And that's so important because sometimes Christians, not us, but other Christians, oh, you're listening good, get caught up in the Bible and in those words in the Bible. And they hold on to those words so tightly that they forget that those words are the inspired, living, breathing word of God. And those words are nothing more than words that through the Holy Spirit give us the faith and the strength and the direction we need. It's not about the words. It's about the faith that is in us. It's about the promises of God. That through Jesus Christ, sin is forgiven. We are made members of a community. We love one another. My favorite saying is no asterisks. We love unconditionally. There's no condition on God's love. And that's why what happened this morning, and there were three gospel stories in that short time. Kind of made my head spin. But in the second one, the wilderness, Jesus went out into the wilderness. And if you read through the Gospel of Mark, there's a number of times when Jesus goes into the wilderness. The next time is going to be after he's spent a wild night healing people and driving out demons. But as you read through Mark, you see the wilderness. And the same author that wrote what I said earlier said, God uses time in the wilderness for God's purposes. time in self-reflection, to take care of yourself, to build yourself up, to recharge, I've seen statistics that in this country, something like 25, 30, 40% of vacation time is not used by people. Because we just like to go, 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 go. Right? Quiet is hard, isn't it? Taking time to care for yourself is hard. Taking time to do nothing is hard. But as we shut off the noise, as we take time for ourselves, as we take time to be in prayer, to study scripture, to look at the world around us, as we do those things, they can strengthen us as the children of God. And it's so important that we find that strength. Because there's so many things that push upon us in our world that tell us that you can't love everybody. There's too many words in our world that are driven by hate, that are driven to divide us. But that's not what it means to live in God's promise. God's promise is unconditional love for everybody. And it's a radical idea, because again, the world doesn't like it. God's promise is also something I heard Sarah do during the song. She punched the word justice. Yeah, I heard it. And that's important, because living in God's love is also about working to bring about justice in the world. To bring about equality, but not equality, to bring about equal opportunity for all. It's about loving all. It's about knowing all. And I know I ramble a little bit every now and then. And I know I say the same thing over and over and over. But until the world gets it, until the world understands, we need to continue to be a beacon that shows that God is love, that love is unconditional, that forgiveness is for all, that when we take time to recharge, we get stronger. The council met last week in retreat. They had a wonderful time. Yeah, I had a lot of extra cookies after it, but it was a good time to recharge, to refocus. And as a people of God, we are called to do that. And as Lutheran Christians, that call comes in water, in holy baptism. Water which washed over us, water which delivers us from all the powers of death and the devil, and all his empty promises. Water that makes us God's children. Live in that covenant. Live under the rainbow. And know that you are loved to love. Amen.
Jesus, to
God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body,
and the life everlasting.
Amen.
Trusting in God's promise to reconcile all things, let us pray for the Church, the well-being of creation, and the world in need. God, our truth, the ark of your Church has room for many expressions of faith. We give thanks for voices that challenge and awaken your people. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God, our Maker, you remember your covenant with the earth and its inhabitants. Rescue communities and creatures hurting from natural disasters. Preserve species and habitats endangered by human carelessness and disregard. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God, our light, you know our weakness. Free all who govern from the temptations of power. Sustain all who work for human rights in every nation. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God, our help, you care for your beloved children. Comfort all who are grieving, ill, afraid, in pain, or in despair. Feed hungry people living in food deserts. Protect any at risk from exploitation and abuse. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God, our home, you gather your people. Grant us health and safety as we assemble. Keep us mindful of any who are homebound, hospitalized, convalescing, or traveling. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God, our hope, you promise eternal life to your beloved children. We remember with gratitude those who have lived and died in faith. Grant that we may also dwell with you in everlasting peace. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Accompany us on our journey, God of grace, and receive the prayers of our heart through Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
We share a sign of God's peace. Thank you.
and also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. You call your people to cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal Feast, that renewed in the gift of baptism we may come to the fullness of your grace. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
I remind you that Jesus is the host of the meal, and all are welcome to receive bread for the journey, a feast for hungry hearts. Come to the table of the Lord. And now the precious body and blood of our Lord and Savior strengthen you and keep you in his grace, now and forever.
Amen.
Generous God, at this table we have tasted your immeasurable grace. As grains of wheat are gathered into one bread, now make us one loaf to feed the world. In the name of Jesus, the bread of life.
Amen.
Can't see that far back. So, yeah.
parking lot today, turn around and look at the west wall of the church. We've been waiting a long time to have our signs put up. It happened this week. We are here. And there's no reason for anybody to say, oh, I belong to First Lutheran. Where's that? They'll know. And we're so delighted to be here. Thank you. Did you all hear that? There's no food pantry run on Tuesday, but there will be food pantry on Thursday.
No, Wednesday.
Other announcements? Otherwise, we'll have kid connection after worship. Beloved, we are God's own people, holy washed, renewed. God bless you and keep you, showering with mercy, fill you with courage, and give you peace.
Amen.
Go in peace. Share your bread.
Thanks be to God.
Just a little bit.